The device chemists use to measure the heat of a reaction is called a calorimeter. Calorimeters are designed to contain the heat released by a chemical reaction. They're thermally insulated, so they don't release the heat of the reaction to the outside. Calorimeters also distribute internal heat evenly and efficiently, have a well-defined heat capacity, and allow for measuring their internal temperature. Let's consider a simple type of calorimeter, the coffee cup calorimeter. It's made of two nested coffee cups, a plastic lid, a stirrer, and a thermometer. It's most useful for finding the heat of a reaction that occurs in aqueous solution. The coffee cups serve as thermal insulation. They keep the heat of the reaction from being transferred out of the calorimeter. There's a lid on this calorimeter, but its contents are at atmospheric pressure all of the time, so it's called a constant pressure calorimeter. The heat you measure with it is the heat at constant pressure, Q sub P, which is equal to the enthalpy change of a reaction, delta H. Shall we carry out a virtual reaction in our coffee cup calorimeter? Let's measure the heat released when the compound lithium iodide dissolves in water. Lithium iodide is an ionic compound. It dissolves into aqueous lithium ions and aqueous iodide ions. The heat of this reaction is called the heat of solution of lithium iodide. We'll start with 10 grams of lithium iodide and 200 grams, that's 200 milliliters, of water. It's important that the starting substances are at the same temperature, the temperature the thermometer reads, before the reaction begins. It's simplest just to leave the lithium iodide and water together at room temperature for a while first. The starting temperature is 22.1 degrees Celsius. Now we begin the reaction. The lithium iodide is added to the water and the mixture is stirred until the solid is completely dissolved. Watch the temperature. Is it going up or down? Is the reaction endothermic or exothermic? The temperature went up, so heat was released. The reaction must be exothermic. The highest temperature reached was 27.4 degrees Celsius. We have collected the data for our experiment. Now it's time to calculate the heat of the reaction. We know that heat was released by the reaction. After the solid had completely dissolved, the heat produced was contained in the 210 grams of solution. How do we assess the heat energy that corresponds to a change in temperature? We have to consider the heat capacity. Remember that heat capacity is equal to the amount of heat transferred divided by the change in temperature. In this case, we can make use of the specific heat capacity, the heat capacity per unit mass of the solution. Remember the equation for specific heat capacity? It's Q, the heat, divided by the mass in grams, and the change in temperature. We can assume that the solution has the same heat capacity as water, 4.18 joules per gram Kelvin. The quantity we want to know is Q, the heat of the reaction. Let's rearrange the equation so we can solve for Q. We just said that the specific heat capacity, C, is 4.18 joules per gram Kelvin. M, the total mass, is 210 grams. The change in temperature, delta T, is equal to the final temperature minus the initial temperature. That's 5.3 degrees Celsius. A temperature change of 5.3 degrees Celsius is equivalent to a temperature change of 5.3 kelvins. Putting all the values into the equation, we get a heat of reaction of 4,700 joules. Since heat was released in the reaction, the sign of Q is negative. This is the heat produced by dissolving 10 grams of lithium iodide. To find the heat released per mole, just divide by the number of moles of lithium iodide in 10 grams. That comes out to 63 kilojoules of heat produced per mole of lithium iodide dissolved. Since the reaction occurred at constant pressure, This heat of reaction is also the enthalpy change of the reaction, so we can use it to write a thermochemical equation for the dissolution of lithium iodide. Measuring the heat of a combustion reaction requires a device that's sturdier than our coffee cup calorimeter. Chemists use a bomb calorimeter to measure heats of combustion. A combustible reactant is placed in a steel bomb, which is a chamber with a tight seal. The bomb is pressurized with pure oxygen, and then it's placed in a water bath in an insulated container. The sample is ignited by an electric current, and the temperature change that results from the reaction is monitored by a thermometer in the water bath. As with the coffee cup calorimeter, the capacity of the bomb calorimeter has to be calculated. That includes the steel bomb and the water bath. In general, the two calorimetry techniques are similar, but there's one important difference. The reaction in the bomb calorimeter occurs at constant volume rather than constant pressure. The heat of the reaction isn't equal to the enthalpy change. It's equal to the internal energy change, delta E. Remember the equation for the first law of thermodynamics, delta E equals Q plus W? Since there's no volume change in the bomb, W, the work, is zero, so that leaves delta E equal to Q, the heat, at constant volume, often written Q sub V. But recall that for most reactions, delta E and delta H are very close in value.